Here we are today. It is February the 25th, 2016. We're just going to do a little show and tell for the public today to help them understand what I've learned. I just want to share it with you just so you can see what I've been through and what I've learned about this wireless radiation we're all being exposed to. You know, I live in Owosso, Oklahoma, and you know, I got a permit from the city of Tulsa to change out my smart meter, which we did. We had a certified electrician do all that, and the inspectors okayed it and all that. But what was interesting, and I just want to help people to understand, when we had both meters off my house, the radiation levels in our bedroom, which is on the south side, was like 700 microwatts per meter squared. And remember, you know, I've got, this is a meter that reads microwave radiation of all these different things that we're being affected by here. And this is the directional antenna, and it's best for me when I work trying to find radiation sources. And it reads 200 microwatts per meter squared, 2,000 microwatts, and we can put a device on there that reads 200,000 microwatts. And so when we did all this, I was shocked when we had no meter on my house to see all the radiation, and I didn't understand that for a day or two. And so I learned what was happening, and I learned I was being exposed to multi-source microwave radiation, not just smart meters, but multi-sources. And so we want to show you today multi-sources of microwave radiation. And to do that, we have a meter with an omnidirectional antenna. So that just reads 360 degrees instead of the green one, which is point, you know, point, and then it just points to where the radiation is coming from. So we're going to, today, we're just going to load up. We're at a place right now that's very quiet, and so I'm going to turn the meter on. It's all the volume's all the way up, and you'll see it's coming down from where it was, but this is like, we're out in the country, obviously. But it's like 9.8, there's 11, 10, 9. And so it's very quiet, you can hear it. It's very quiet here, and it's very safe here in the country because, you know, there's very little radiation coming in on us. So we're gonna take this meter, and we're gonna go into Tulsa, and we're gonna start on Admiral and Sheridan, North Sheridan, and then we're gonna go south to 131st Street, south on Sheridan. And so we're just going to take a shot down through there, and we're going to show you the amount of radiation we're being exposed to 360 degrees. So, you know, the probably three biggest sources is cell towers, communication antennas, and smart meters. I mean, PSO has put in smart meters recently, and they're in this mesh grid network, so, you know, there can be transmitting from court documents 14 to 190,000 times a day. So they're just blanketing everything. And that's not discounting Oklahoma Natural Gas's meters, which are also transmitting. And then the you know, Tulsa's starting to put in water meters that are wireless, okay? So there's a multitude of radiations. There's people's cell phones, their cars, you know, they're transmitting inside their cars. There's lots of different things out there. So we just want to show you the levels. That's all we're interested in. And then you can make the decisions of what you think about all this. Because, you know, if you look at some documents, this is Dr. Magna Havas, and she wrote a paper back in 2013. It's called Radiation from Wireless Technology's Effects on the Blood, Heart, and Autonomic Nervous System. But she has a chart in there, and it shows 2002 the amount of Wi-Fi networks in the United States, and then got a little bit more in 2004 and 2008. 2012 got pretty wild and pretty crazy, and what today's 2016 now, we're really there. But she has a bar graph there, and she shows you the closer you are to the source, you have some health effects and damaging health effects, and like fatigue, sleep disturbances, headaches, feeling of discomfort, difficulty concentrating, depression, memory loss, visual disturbances, irritability, hearing disruptions, skin problems, cardiovascular dizziness, loss of appetite, movement difficulties, and nausea. And so we'll put this up for you to see, but we just kind of want to give you a quick review of that. And so not only are we dealing with those kind of issues, this is Ronald M. Powell back in June the 11th, 2013, and he's looking at the biological effects from radiation at low intensity exposures, and based on the Bioinitiative Report 2012, and the implications from smart meters and smart appliances. And so we'll put this up for you too. But here, you'll see the FCC standards up here in blue. The Bioinitiative Report is down here in yellow. But yet we have 67 peer-reviewed studies showing biological damage below the FCC standard. Because see, this is non-ionizing, non-thermal radiation being pulsed at us. And so we just want to let you see those things. And so these are just some tools. This equipment is just tools to help you to see. And then there's a thing the public can go to if they like. You can go to antennasearch.com on the internet. And like we did this particular, let's see, there's we did three for you to look at. And on our little trip we're going to do, first we started just to show you. This is about 4th and Harvard. There's 138 cell towers and 373 communication antennas. And so you can actually look here, and that little red dot right in the middle is where a home is. And then there's the cell towers around it, okay? And this one said there's like 138 towers. And on the communications antennas right there, they're saying there's 373 antennas. Well, all that is wireless microwave radiation. So that's just kind of a general reading we'll show you. But we have a special reading at 41st and Sheridan, which we'll drive through here in a little while. And at that intersection, we can reference it. There's 231 cell towers and 603 antennas. And then as we drive through the 71st and Sheridan intersection, there'll be 123 towers. All that is within a 4-mile radius. All these are in a 4-mile radius. And there's 344 antennas. So we're just trying to let you see. The public, I didn't understand any of this 3 years ago when I started. And so I've had to learn these things. And because you can't feel, hear, see, touch this stuff. You don't even know what's happening. And so we want to show you how dense it is now. And we want to show you that there's some health problems to all this. And so you can be the decider of what you want to do about it all and what you want to do to remedy it. But we want to show you first, it's out there, it's happening, okay? And then the other thing is you can protect yourself, because when I learned all this back November 7th, 2012, I had two major health issues. And so Dr. Dietrich Klinghardt, smart meters, the health crisis of our time, EMR radiation. It's a 43-minute YouTube, but you can pull up. I did some things to protect myself, and within a short amount of hours, from a Friday afternoon to a Saturday morning, two major health symptoms went away. So all this is, this is not hard to understand. It's just cause and effect. It's just like, you know, if you have a campfire and you're sitting there and you're getting smoke in your eyes and you're breathing the stuff, it's just because you're standing in the smoke. So all you have to do is get out of the smoke. And so this radiation is the same way. But the trouble is you can't see it, hear, or smell like you do smoke. But if you can get out of it, you'll get better, as long as you haven't, you know, gotten to the point where you got some kind of cancer or something like that. So we're just trying to help the public understand that there's issues to all this. There's a cost to all this wireless. And you can make the decision, you know, if you think it's a big thing or not, or you can do nothing, or you can maybe do to protect yourself, because where you sleep is the crucial point of all this. And so that's what we had to do at my house, is protect ourselves. So we want to help you do that. So now we're going to load up, and we're going to go to town, and we're going to take that drive on down from Admiral and North Sheridan. We're going to go south. Okay, here we are. We're getting ready to start our trek from North Sheridan to South Sheridan and just give you a review of how much the radiation is. Remember, we're using omnidirectional, which is taking it from all sources instead of our directional, which we talked about in the beginning. So we're going to start here on Sheridan and Admiral, North Sheridan, and we're going to start. Now, we're going to turn the meter on, and remember the meter readings are 200 and 2,000 microwatts, and so where we're sitting right now, it's over 2,000. So we want you to see the meter, so we're going to hold it up here, and it's on 200, so take a look at that. Remember, when the meter goes to the left, that means it's over 200. So like we'll go to 2,000 now, and it's actually over 2,000 here. And I'm going to turn the volume up so you get a hear. Remember, the louder the noise, the worse the radiation, which it is bad here. So let's listen. Okay. So we're going to start, and then if it drops, I'll lower the reading. Okay. So you'll have to be patient with us a little bit. But there's a lot of sources right here. And remember, you can go to antennasearch.com, and that will help you see the sources. And remember, today we're reading multiple sources of microwave radiation. PSO has deployed their smart meters here in Tulsa. Okay, so we're off. We're going through the intersection of Admiral right now. Okay, it's starting to maybe drop because we're getting away a little bit, unless we hit another source. Okay, but see, it's 1,500. There's 9. We got to get below 200 before we can go back to the 200 setting on this meter. See, it's dropping now. We just came through that. See, it's still a little high, 7,400. But we're traveling south now. Still not below 200, and as soon as it gets there, we'll switch. We couldn't get all the green lights to go at the same time, so we have to stop. There it went, and we just went a second ago. Let's go to 200. Okay, now it's reading at 200. Okay, here we go. Okay. We have to go to 2,000 now, because it's going over the 200, but we're coming up to more sources of radiation. See, there's 800, 1,200, and see, remember now, we're passing behind these big buildings, so a building will absorb the radiation. We're coming up to another. This is 11th Street here. See, it's sometimes pushing over 2,000 right there. So the building, remember, wireless, all it is raw electricity being blasted at us. And subtly electrocuting us. So see, this is still really high, 6,500. So as you're traveling the streets, you know, going to work or shopping or whatever, you're being inundated with this wireless. You watch these horror movies. Here we go. We're on 11th now, going south on Sheridan. You see these horror movies, like I think I saw these spider movies where everything was getting covered with spider webs. Well, if you could visualize, this radiation is now blanketing this city with all this radiation, right? And we just want to show you how much is here today. You know, it's around 1 o'clock. It's over 2,000. See, 19, 18. Okay, so we're coming into a really hot area again. What, just from 11th Street to 15th Street? And as you pass through different buildings and things, it kind of blocks it depending where the source is coming from. Okay, we just went below 200. See, that's 113.8. So, see, that's under 200, and the meter can read that. But when it gets up to over 200, well, then it can't read it any longer. So, we're good. See, it's pushing it now. Okay. So it went over 200. We can't read that any longer. So, we're going to have to go to a higher reading. Okay, now, see, we just went past a retaining wall, and it's blocking the source. Okay, so we're getting ready to go back up now here in a minute. We've got two sources coming up. See, there's 4,500. See, that's way over 200, double 200. And so you're there, 14, 18, 17, 15 microwatts per meter squared. Okay, that's micro. See, that's over 2,000 now. Microwatts per meter squared. Now we're coming up to 21st Street here. It's over 2,000. Meter can't read more than that unless we put a device on there that it can read 200,000. And we really don't need to know that at the moment. We're just showing you these high levels as we cross these intersections going south. So we're on East 21st Street in Sheridan. It's over 2,000 microwatts per meter squared. Okay, here we go. You hear that boop, boop, boop? That is a common cell tower signature on this meter. That's all that is. The meter lets you know what you're kind of listening to. So remember, there's an intermix of a lot of different things. And the closer the source, the stronger it's going to read on this meter. So since we've started from Admiral, things have been pretty hot. There's like 1,200. Okay, we're getting ready to come up on 31st. 2000, there's several sources coming up at this intersection of this radiation. Over 2000. Okay, this is East 31st Street. And remember, we're using an omnidirectional antenna on this meter. We have the directional, you saw it, it's the green one. And I use that for detection more than, you know, omnidirectional, because I'm looking for the sources when I go into places to see where they're coming from. So this is omnidirectional, so we're getting communications antennas, cell towers, smart meters, people's cell phones. I mean, people right next to us here can be on their cell phone or tablets or whatever. Even the cars are transmitting today. It just depends on your car. Like, you know, they have Bluetooth. And so that's, we can actually pick that up. So there's a lot of different things here. It's not, here we go. This is East 31st. Going south on Sheridan. Hear that boop, boop, boop? It's a common signature to hear. You know, Wi-Fi has its signature. You know, portable house deck phones, they have their signature. And again, we're over, way over 200. And remember, when you go out to the country readings, when you're away from all this radiation, on this meter is 000. And like if we would pull into any metal building that was closed in, low windows or skylights, it would be 0.1 in a metal building. Which is very safe. Okay, now we're going under a overpass. See how the meter dropped? You're being protected there because the radiation was being blocked. So an underpass, you can tell the difference pretty quickly there. Okay, we're going down below 200. Wait, there's back. I thought we were for a second. We're running around 260. Well, I'll just show you what happens when we go. See, it pegs it. It can't read it. It's pretty close to 200 there. Okay, we're coming up to another overpass in just a minute. Okay, 36. This is actually Highway I-44. Skelly Drive. We're getting ready to go under the I-44 highway. Okay, here we go. Watch the meter now. It's a long one. Okay, watch, boom. There, 270. See how it dropped? 219. Okay, now we're coming back out. And look at the difference. Okay, but there's some other buildings right near us. Okay, now this is 41st and Sheridan. We have a antennasearch.com reference to this intersection on how many communication antennas and how many cell towers are on this intersection. So we'll show you that here. When we get ready to put those on for you. Okay, now we're still back on 2000. Remember, this is going south on 43rd Street, East 43rd Street now. Okay, now it's below 200. Let me flip it. There. Okay, now, see, it'll read 200, but there's a huge building to my right, and there's a retaining wall, and so we're being a little bit protected right here. There's 66, you know, 54. It depends where the source of the radiation's coming from, but if we took this meter and put it right against that concrete wall, it might read, you know, like 0.8 or 0.6. Okay, here we go again, 49, 200. We're gonna get back out in it now, we'll see. There it went. So, I turned it off. Sorry. Turned it off. Hit the wrong switch. So now we're back up to 15. There's 100. Let's go back to 200. Okay, it's over 200, so we have to go back to the 2000 mark. So there's 400, 500. $13, $15, $17. Push it 2000 again. We're coming into a really hot... really hot intersection. Over 10,000. This is 51st, East 51st and South Sheridan Road. It's pretty hot right here, you can tell. So it's right around 2000, which is a lot of radiation. When you're sleeping at night, you want zero radiation. You want the meter to read zero. You don't want this much, because you can't repair. You know, your pineal gland won't make melatonin. You can't repair when there's this much radiation. So you know people buy canopies, hang from their around their bed like mosquito netting, which will help protect you. And so you remember, this is about showing you. Many of you for the first time have never got to see here. You can't touch, see, you know, this stuff, can't smell it. Your senses can't detect it unless you're extremely sick. You're hypersensitive. And then, you know, you probably feel it, because I know people that can feel it just being around it. And they're better meters than my meter to be able to read things. And so you want to protect yourself. Remember, that's what I did. And my major health symptoms went away almost immediately when I started learning how to protect myself from all this. Okay, so here we go again, East 51st, South Sheridan Road. This is kind of a hot intersection, so you can tell from these readings. So, you know, you just go in and out of this as you're traveling, and you don't even know it. And we're not trying to curtail your travel or anything. All we're trying to do is show you what's happening, and then you can make all the decisions you want to make. You can do the studies. You know, you have a computer and you have the internet. You know, you just have to punch stuff in and start learning about what's happening. But it's a big issue. Okay, see, we're pushing over 2000 again now. 17, 16, 2000 again. This is a hot intersection too. 1000. Okay, we're coming up on 61st, East 61st Street in Sheridan. Over 2000. Okay, we're starting to get a little distance now. Remember, distance is your friend. In a few minutes, we'll be coming up on 71st in Sheridan. And we have another antennasearch.com reference. We have a picture of the number of cell towers and the number of communications antennas. But just think, all these homes, okay, it just went below 200 because we just went past this hill. Okay, see, it's okay to read at 200 now, but we're down below some hills, which blocks the source. Okay, now we're coming up on another source up here on 71st. We have another reference I was just telling you here for you to look at. So you can see what's at this intersection. See, it's starting to drop now again. But we're behind some trees, but there's another hill and trees to our right. So that's kind of blocking the source. And then as soon as we pop out of these trees right here up on the intersection, they'll probably go back up over 2000. We'll see. Let's look here a minute. Okay, see, it's 76700, and so that's over 200, so that we can't go down to 200. But you know, you have to understand, every place you have these extremely high levels of radiation in your home, you know, could be inundated coming right through your walls. This is microwave radiation, it goes through things. You know, that's how your microwave oven works. It cooks things that way. It goes right through things. Okay, so here we are, East 71st, South Sheridan. Remember, we're going to have a reference on this intersection. Okay, it's over 2000 just there. We just went petting out. We're going down a hill and we have trees and low areas. See, it's dropping now. Okay, we're down to 180. So it's right on that, it's right on the verge of 200. See, there's 700. And here's another very important thing to know is during the winter time, all the leaves are dead, you know, and there's no leaves. Well, the leaves help block radiation. That's why in Canada, they pulled 36,000 meters because in the rural areas, the leaves and everything were blocking the radiation. And after 5 years, they quit. They pulled them. Or they didn't maybe pull the meters, they pulled the cards. And they're going to have to go read it by hand, I think, was what happened. Okay, so let's look now here. We'll go back to 200. See, we're down in that low area. Low is always good. Okay, we're coming up on 81st and Sheridan, which is a hot spot. See, the meter couldn't take the 200 any longer. Okay, so they're 18, 19. It's pushing 2,000. On that. So now we're at East 81st and Sheridan. So we have some things around this that will help block. We're sitting a little lower. So see, it's still over 200. It's 3 something. So in the summertime, you have more protection. The leaves protect you better than the wintertime. In the wintertime, there's not much protection. So that's like, there's 300, 200. It's still over 200 to safely go to 200. East 81st and Sheridan. Remember, you hear the boop, boop, boop again. That's pretty common. And remember, I think I'm pretty sure and safe to say that most of these houses all have TSO's smart meters. You know, they're all transmitting court record 14 to 190,000 times a day. So there's a mesh grid network. And remember the spider movie? Everything's covered with spider webs. It's like they put a spider's webs all over the city, but it's radiation. Okay, let's see now. We're kind of getting back on some more rural setting type roads. We'll see what it says down this road. If it'll drop below 200, I don't know. It's getting close. There it is. Okay, now there's a huge hill to my right. It doesn't seem to be stopping it because there's a source that must be up on it. So there's 800-900. And one of the problems with this stuff, the radiation, is they coined it back in, I think it was 1932, the Germans, 1932-36, is microwave sickness. And people that ran radars and all these different things, and people who were around it, there we went by a really low place just then. Okay, we're coming back up on another hot intersection. This is 91st in Sheridan. And so they get, from this all this radiation, you get what they call microwave sickness. And so you go to your physician, and you kind of want to find, see, that's over 2,000. So you go to your physician and you don't want to see what's going on because you need to look at all these health symptoms associated with this stuff. And they, you know, it's not that they just don't know about it because they haven't probably been trained. But what I've learned is as soon as you get it off of you, get away from it, protect yourself, then you can start restoring, especially at night. But, you know, if you're in these high intersections, your houses, and you're being inundated, coming right through your home where you sleep, this is a simulation, this wireless, of sunlight. And sunlight tells your body not to fix, tells your melatonin not to. See, we just dropped in a really low place right there. There's a real low place. You see how low the meter went, how quiet it got? Now we're coming back out. And this will be, I think this is coming up 101st. Okay, yeah, get ready. So here we go. Over 2,000. Okay, this is 100 East 101st in Sheridan. 14, 17. But see, first you have to know that the stuff's here, and we're trying to help you to see that. And then you decide if the health issues are there and if they're bothering you, I guess. Dr. Klinghart would probably let you know that they... Okay, now we're going in a rural trees, two-lane road. We'll go to 200. Look at the difference. That is huge. See, 27, 23. This is huge. Now we're going down to another really low place in the road, and we got walls and trees, the trunks. I mean, you know, they're protection out on the back, the other direction towards Admiral. You know, there was no protection except maybe big buildings. But look at the difference in the readings here. 24, 12. That's almost getting good. You know. Okay, here's another really low place in the road. I'm gonna go down, coming out. And this is 111th, East 111th in Sheridan Road. It's getting more residential, less commercial. Okay, we're at 200. See, we can keep our meter at 200 now. See the difference? When we're coming through town, it was like over 2,000. Okay, there. That is a deck phone we just went past. You can hear it buzzing. That was a deck phone. Okay, 17, 18. See, there's multi sources of radiation with all this. There was Wi-Fi just then. Going by too fast to read them. But it's interesting, you can take these meters and walk around the outside of a house, and you can tell what rooms the Wi-Fi, the deck phones, and you can especially read the smart meters, but you may have to quiet. And the point is, we all have wireless in our homes, but that's a choice, a decision that we can choose to either stop or not. But communications antennas and cell towers and smart meters, they're being forced, but you don't even know that's happening to you. Okay, we're coming up on 121st. Okay, we gotta go 2000. Let's see what it get here. We're 121st South, East 121st in Sheridan. Now, okay, let's see, it's going down below. So this is back up. Okay, 22. See, we're getting more rural. And let me tell you, there's nothing in this car that's pulsing. We don't have anything on this car that pulses. The newer cars, there's an issue with all that radiation. Now we're coming to the end of Sheridan. We're far enough south, we're coming up to the Arkansas River, and we didn't have a boat today, or there's no ferries at least. So we'll probably have to stop our experiment here. And then we might have a little conclusion to the end of this once we get safely out of the traffic and stopped. And we just wanted to drive through and let you see what's here, let you do the research. We might leave you some links to look at. See, look, 16, 17, 22. This is as far as 131st, East 131st in Sheridan. This is as far as I can go, unless I go through some backyards. Okay, well, thank you very much for watching, and we'll try to give you a conclusion here in a minute. Thank you. Okay, we're back from our little trip we took. We went into Tulsa, got that from Admiral and Sheridan, and we drove south. And so we did that. We went by the 41st Street, the 71st Street. You saw those charts. We're going to have those charts up for you to see in there. And then, we did all this. We showed you the multi-sources of microwave radiation. It's the cell towers. It's the antennas. It's Oklahoma natural gas. It's the water meters. It's people's cell phones. Wi-Fi's, deck phones, all that's out there. It's happening. There's a cost to this radiation. If you look into the documents, if you look at the military men that did this for their livelihood, for 26 years, they're telling you there's a cost. And so we just want to show you first, and last now, because we're at the end, that it's out there, but you can't see it. We want to help you see it and know what's happening, and then let you make the decisions on what you want to do with all this. And I really thank you for watching this. I appreciate you. Thanks.